We shall now demonstrate the analysis of the mean backscatter values from the Sentinel-1 images using the RStudio software. A code was written, and in this code, in this R code, the first part of the code reads the data which was summarized in a table. It extracts the backscatter values as well as the days of the year when the images were taken. After extraction, then the values are plotted for all the images that are appearing and for each and every field. After that, the code is run. The results of the R statistic processing are as displayed in this PDF document. The red curve symbolizes the images collected in 2015, whereas the blue curve indicates the images collected in 2016. The vertical lines appearing on the left side of the graphs indicate the time when the maize fields were planted, whereas the lines appearing on the right side of the graphs indicate when the maize fields were harvested. What is interesting to note is that in instances when the planted dates for the 2 years were coincidental, then the curves were almost similar. An example of this we can see in a field like L10. The field L10, the planting dates for the 2015 and 2016 seasons were coincident, and therefore you can see that the curve had minimal deviation. For fields whose planting dates were quite a distance apart, you find that there were a big discrepancy between the two curves. This happened especially during the early stages of growth. However, as the plants proceeded, you find that the curve started being coincidental and could be identical to each other. This therefore means that despite the planting dates being far apart from each other, at the fruiting season, when the fields are already covered by the leaves, you find that the maize backscatter values are similar and they stabilize. Therefore means that in case there's any outlier in the growth, then the farmer can use that as an indication that there's a problem in the field and therefore take any necessary action in order to mitigate any crop losses that might arise from that.